إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار فأوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله. Brothers in Iman, we want to talk about leaving this world unprepared. Living in this world, exit, when you exit, when you leave this world, you leave it when you are not prepared. You wasted a lot of time. You spent time, but not on beneficial things. ضَيَّعْتَ حَيَاتَكَ فِي الدُّنْيَا. You lost it. Allah Azza wa Jalla says on the day of Qiyamah, people will have different types of regret. One of the worst regrets for a Muslim who was guided to al-Islam and granted Iman, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestowed Hidayah on him, is يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِي. يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِي قَدَّمْتُ لِحَيَاتِي. Have you ever thought and reflected on that ayah? Allah is not talking about somebody else. He's talking about you. And he created you, خَلَقَكَ ثُمَّ رَزَقَكَ ثُمَّ هَدَاكَ لِلْإِسْلَامِ. هَدَاكَ إِلَى الْإِسْلَامِ. Created you, sustained you, and he guided you to Islam. And you did not receive that Islam. You did not submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kafa. كما قال الله سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا دخلوا في السلم كافة ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان. Oh, you who believe, enter into the fold of Islam, submit to Allah totally and completely. ولا تتبعوا خطوات الشيطان إنه لكم عدو مبين. And do not follow the footsteps of Shaytan, for Shaytan to you is an enemy. You did not listen to udkhulu fi silmi kafa. What you listen to, ittiba'i khutwati shaytan. So al-insan, that person on the day of qiyamah, yaqulu ya laytani qaddamtu li hayati. I wish if I sent something forward in my account with Allah, I wish if I sent someone, if I did something meaningful, something beneficial for my life in dunya, that would have helped me and saved me from today's torment and horrifying moments on the day of prayer. يَقُولُ يَا لَيْتَنِ. That is an nadam, but that day, such regrets will not help, my brothers and sisters in Islam. So do not set yourself for such regrets. Brothers in Iman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاتَّبِعُوا أَحْسَنَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَكُمُ الْعَذَابُ بَغْتَةً وَأَنْتُمْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. مَا الْعَمَلُ؟ Somebody should be saying, should be asking himself, what is this that I'm required to do? Allah say, wattabi'u. What you are required to do is simple. Follow. Do. Act upon ma unzila ilaykum min rabbikum. Not ittiba'il hawa. La. Do not follow your desires. Do not follow shaitan. Follow that which has been sent to you from your Lord. We have it in Al-Quran. As explained by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ittabi'u ma unzila ilaykum min rabbikum. This is what is required of you. Min qabli an ya'tiyakum al-'adhabu baghtatan. Follow that. Because time, before time expires, and punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaces that awqatun ni'am, zamanun ni'am, ni'mar of al-Islam, ni'mar of al-afiyah, ni'mar of hidayah, ni'mar of iman, ni'mar of al-haya fi hadha dunya. Follow that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent you. Make effort to follow it before the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to you suddenly. Min qabli an ya'tiyakum al-'adhabu baghtatan wa antum la tash'urun, when you perceive not. You know, al-insan has the following to say on the day of Qiyamah. Allah blesses him with ni'mah, and he does not take good care of that ni'mah. Wa akbaru ni'am is ni'matul Islam. Wa ma kunna linahtadiya lawla an hadana Allah. There is no greater ni'mah like ni'mah of la ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. There is no comparison. The ratio is zero if you want to compare all ni'mah. Now, human being set himself for a failure, wasting time in this world, focusing on temporary issues more than permanent, meeting with Allah. أن تقول نفس يا حسرة على ما فرطت في جنب الله وإن كنت لمن الساخرين. He starts regretting on the day of Qiyamah. Oh, أن تقول نفس. Oh, woe unto me. I regret because of the time that I wasted in dunya. على ما فرطت في جنب الله. Allah created me and guided me. He sent Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam liyuta'a bi'idhni. Oh, I regret. On the day of Qiyamah, he's regretting. An taqula nafsun ya hasrata ala ma farrattu fi jambillah wa in kuntu lamina sakhirin. He said that I was mocking, I was joking, I was scoffing. I took the whole Islam and Iman for a jest and for mockery. أو تقول لو أن الله هداني لكنت من المتقين. Or you say, oh, had Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided me, I would have been among the good people. Allah guided you. Allah azza wa jalla guided you. Allah guided you to al-Islam. Allah sent down al-Quran. Allah sent, appointed Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to guide you. Allah guided you even after Rasulullah had died. What are we doing now on the minbar at this sa'ah, if not reminding? So you do not have an excuse. That is a lame and crippled excuse. لو أن الله هداني الله هداك لقد هداك الله. It is you who did not take it seriously. It is you. أو تقول حين ترى العذاب. Or he will say, when he will be seeing the punishment on the day of Qiyamah, لو أن لي كرة فأكون من المحسنين. Please, if I had a time, if I only had a time in dunya so that I can be among the righteous, I would have done a lot of good deeds. What time didn't you have? كم أعمارنا كم عمرك كم عشت في الدنيا. None of us in this masjid is below 15. All of us are adults, as I can see. بالغ عاقل. All of us. Some of us are 20. Some of us are 25, 30. And I can see we are going up and we are having some elders in the masjid. They have تجاوز ماذا 60 من العمر. What is this time and days that you are complaining about that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not give you? فلذلك قال الحسن البصري رحمه الله حسن البصري says يا ابن آدم إنما أنت أيام فإذا ذهب بعضك فإذا ذهب يومك ذهب بعضك. You are only days yourself. The day comes, you should consider that yesterday a portion of me is gone. And another day comes, you should consider that my hand is gone. Another day my head is gone. If you are to be measured with days and you are told, listen, you are only 1 week. That is your new name. And if a day goes, your legs will be gone. And if another day, your waist will be gone. How much are you going to work towards righteousness? How much are you going to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How much are you going to improve your Islam? Brothers in Iman, Kana Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu anhu إِذَا وَقَفَ عَلَى قَبْرٍ بَكَى حَتَّى يَبُلَّ لِحْيَتَهُ. Hadith is collected by Imamuna al-Tirmidhi, Abu Isa wa Hassanahu al-Bani, rahimahullah, that whenever Uthman ibn Affan stood on a grave, somebody is in the grave being buried, أَوْزَارَ قَبْرًا, or he visited a grave, whenever he stood on a grave, especially when they were burying the dead, baka, he wept. He cried so much, hatta yabulla lihyatahu, until his beard were full of tears. Faqila lahu, those around him told him, oh Uthman, Jannah is mentioned and Jahannam is mentioned, and we don't see you crying like this. But just by standing on the grave, you are crying like this. فقال سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول. He said, I heard the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say, إن القبر أول منازل الآخرة. That verily, grave is the first stage, first station, first destination of Akhirah. Grave is the first stage of Akhirah, of the stages of Akhirah. فإن نجا منه فما بعده أيسر منه أو أيسر منه. He says that whoever succeeds in the grave, whoever answers the su'al of man rabbuka, who is your Lord, whoever answers a question of ma dinuka, whoever answers the question of who is this man called Muhammad, what did you know about him? What was your relationship with him? How much did you follow him? فَمَنْ نَجَى مِنْهُ فَمَا بَعْدَهُ أَيْسَرُ مِنْهُ. Whoever succeeds in the grave, because there is su'al in the grave, يعني مَلَكَان سَيَنْزِلَان. Two angels will come, and immediately before people leaves, they will be asking you questions about your Lord, your deen, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, together with your a'mal. If you succeed, then Rasul said, anything that follows after that will be easy for you. وَإِنْ لَمْ يَنْجُ مِنْ. And whosoever doesn't succeed, your relationship with Allah in dunya was not strong. Your relationship with your deen was not strong. You are a part-time Muslim. And your relationship with Rasulullah was not that strong. You followed so-called celebrities and musicians and this and that. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you followed shaitan and hawa nafs. You followed what you thought made you so smart. I think, and it doesn't make sense to me. Any other thing made sense to you except umuruddin? Qala Allah did not make sense to you. Qala Rasul did not make sense to you. But any other thing made 100% sense to you. On the day of Qiyamah, in this grave, starting in the grave, if you do not succeed to answer the questions in the grave, then anything that follows will be difficult and hard on you. From that time, until all stage, فَفَرِيقٌ فِي الْجَنَّةِ وَفَرِيقٌ فِي السَّعِيرِ. Either one group will go to Jannah or Jahannam. اللهم أدخلنا الجنة وأعذنا من النار. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us from Jahannam and admit us in Jannah. Amen. Brothers, it is said that Ali bin Abi Talib said the following. He advised the ummah by saying, تَزَوَّدْ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا فَإِنَّكَ لَتَدْرِي إِذَا جُنَّ لَيْلٌ هَلْ تَعِيشُ إِلَى الْفَجْرِ. Please listen to this carefully. He say, take some provision, some good provision. Work hard. Commit yourself. Devote yourself to take some good deeds in this dunya. Do not come and live in this dunya having collected nothing that is going to help you on the day of Qiyamah. Tazawwad min ad-dunya. Take a'mal of taqwa. Take a'mal of saliha. Take good righteous deeds. Collect good deeds with you in this dunya. فَإِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي, because you do not know. إِذَا جُنَّ لَيْلٌ, when night comes, because you are living now, this is daytime, and you say, oh, I'm going to do this and this and that, and maybe most of your plans is only dunya, and you do not have any plan with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now, night comes, فَإِنَّكَ لَا تَدْرِي إِذَا جُنَّ لَيْلٌ هَلْ تَعِيشُ إِلَى الْفَجْرِ. You do not know if you're going to live until Fajr. He continued saying, somebody may say, but I'm not sick. Alastu maridan. Wahadihi ishara. And this is maybe a proof that, you know, I'm not going to die now. I'm healthy. I just went to the doctor. I'm clean. I have no corona. He say, وَكَمْ مِنْ صَحِيْهٍ مَاتَ مِنْ غَيْرِ إِلَّهِ. How many people are healthy? They came from their doctor. Everything is clean. Their weight in America, they even weigh the weight. They tell you, please, there is two extra. You need to work out, right? You need to burn the calories, right? They are telling me in America. I didn't know that, where I came from. وَكَمْ مِنْ صَحِيْهٍ. How many of healthy people? Mata min ghayri illa. They died without any sickness. They died without any corona. They died without any accident. They died because their time was up. Wa kam min saqimin aasha hina min ad-dahri. How many people are in ICU? How many people are so sick that family started congregating, assembling, and having meetings saying, I think we need to measure this person. How large his coffin is going to be. We need to prepare a funeral. Some people even called funeral homes because their loved ones, their mother, their sons, their what, were on a life supporting machine, and they said, we don't think if he is going to make it or she's going to make it by evening. But wallahi, these people lived for years and years again. Sick people lived for years and years. Some of them, doctors wrote them off. Doctor called the family and say, this person is gone. He's not going to make it for 3 days. They are making it for 30 years today. وَكَمْ مِنْ صَحِيْهٍ مَاتَ مِنْ غَيْرِ إِلَّا. Then he continued saying, وَكَمْ مِنْ صِغَارٍ يُرْتَجَ طُولُ عُمْرِهِمْ وَقَدْ دُفِنَتْ أَجْسَادُهُمْ ظُلْمَةَ الْقَبْرِ. How many young people were born and people celebrated and they started saying, oh, my son is going to grow and grow and I'm going to send him to university. And once he gets 2, 3, 4 degrees, my son is going to be an engineer and a scientist and my daughter is going to be a gynecologist. All these plans, I want to see my children growing. وَقَدْ دُفِنَتْ أَجِسَادُهُمْ وَقَدْ دُفِنَتْ أَجِسَادُهُمْ ظُلْمَةَ الْقَبْرِ. Little did you know that their bodies is already prepared to be buried in the darkness of the grave. وَكَمْ مِنْ عَرُوسٍ زَيَّنُوهَا لِزَوْجِهَا. How many brides, women, they planned their marriages. Brothers planned their marriages. They decorated them. They decorated them ready. Yani with all the clothes that, you know, some of them are putting, there is haram part of those clothes. And inshallah, I hope Muslims come back to doing halal nikah, halal walima, halal hafla. There is too much haram in most of what we are doing. Maybe this is one of the reasons why our marriages are not succeeding, are falling apart. You start your marriage with haram. Kasiyat, ariyat, women are dancing naked, nude. Men are mixing with men. People are drinking. What? Al-ikhtilat. Whatever they are singing in this is not. And then we say, inshallah, this marriage is going to work. How is it going to work when it is based on a very, very fake and weak yani foundation? But how many brides were prepared for their husbands? But it happens that yani wakad yani their bodies yani wakad nusijat akfanuha wa hiya la tadri. They forgot that the white cloth they had. Just 2 minutes after that, they will be placed in a kafan without them knowing. Brothers in iman, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam advised us and say, أَكَثِرُ مِنْ ذِكْرِ هَادِمِ اللَّذَّاتِ. He say, if there is something we need to remember much, if there is something we need to remember more frequent, is death and malakul maut. And so allow me to conclude with the following. You heard what happened on Wednesday. We have a Muslim family, a husband, a wife, their kid, less than 2 years old, the sister, and one of their relatives. Police says that somebody came and set that house on fire. Green Valley here. Somebody came and set a house on fire. This is what police says. Investigation is still on. There were almost 8 families in that house. The owner of the house and this family tend to have rented this house from the owner. So this person came. So it is arson, right? He came and set the house on fire. 3 people escaped. Allah helped them. But 5 people, a husband and wife, who were only married 2 years ago with an infant, a sister and another cousin, died. Muslims from Senegal. They prayed in our masajid. One of the close brothers says that I met with a husband and wife the eve before that incident, because that happened after midnight. And neighbors only realize that this is happening at what time? Almost Fajr, morning time, they see smoke, which means it is possible that these people had died long time, many hours before that. This has been a very, very big news. Brother Jibril and the family, we say, Allahumma aghfir lahum, warhamhum, wa askinhum fil jannah. I want you to think for 1 minute. I want you to think for a second. We came for American dream. Came for American dream. Everybody came here for different reasons, valid reasons, for studies, for economic reasons, because of wars and chaos in our countries, because of persecution and bad governance, right? Because of just bad environment. None of us would have left his country to America. None of us. Not even me. Not even me. I loved my village. I loved Al-Bi'a, Al-Islami. Na'am. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, we are here. We appreciate that we have our peace. We appreciate that, you know, we have our freedom of worship. We appreciate that we are having